The difficulty for us is that we're placed in a rough position because we swore an oath to uphold the Constitution, federal Constitution, and the state Constitution. And so law enforcement struggles with having a state that allows something that the federal government doesn't. And then with the passage of Amendment 64, what it does is it opens up a whole new realm of, I guess, questions for us, because we don't know what our role is in enforcement. So we have a citizen calls us up and says, I smell a lot of marijuana coming from this house, or I see a lot of trafficking in and out of the house. And so our neighborhoods are our best witnesses. And because of that, I've got to tell them we can't do that anymore. We can't investigate marijuana cases anymore, because there's no ability for me to follow up on that. There's nowhere to go with it. I think most people voted on, same like medical marijuana, they voted for the true sick to have some sort of pain medication to ease the pain. Well, so they couldn't get that through prescription drugs, so they decided let's use marijuana to do this. And I think most people compassionately voted for that. And what happened, though, and it quickly does this, it went from compassion to capitalism. And once they exploited that and opened up these retail centers and started selling it, it opened up a market base. And it turned from compassion to capitalism overnight. And that's where you saw this giant explosion in people using marijuana. And so we're seeing more marijuana grown in these houses. We're encountering more marijuana plants concealed in these clandestine areas, which are houses and basements and people and apartment buildings where people live. And so we're starting to see a huge exploitation of the medical marijuana business. Well, you're going to see youth impacted the most. You're going to see youth use rise dramatically. You're going to see people driving under the influence of marijuana dramatically increase. You're going to see this time and time again. People are going to get hurt over this thing because you've taken a harmful substance and you've compounded the issues we have with prescription drugs and already alcohol. As law enforcement, I think we've got to decide, do we walk away? Do we fold our cards and walk away on marijuana? And it's a federal problem, so contact your local DEA office if there's an issue.